Hi, my name is Nicole Ardoin. I'm a faculty member in the Stanford Graduate School of Education and the Woods Institute for the Environment. And today we're going to be talking about sense of place and the connection of place with environmental education. So I'd just like to start by talking about one of the challenges within studying sense of place and connection to place, and in particular thinking about it with environmental education, is that sense of place is, it's like a fish swimming through water. It's one of those things that it's really hard to have people reflect on their connection to place, and in particular study it, because it's one of those things that's around us all the time. I actually love to say to people that one of my favorite things about studying place is that it's one of those things, it's an equal opportunity research topic, because everyone has something to say about place. Keith Basso, who is an ethnographer who studies the Western Apache, he lived with them for more than 3 decades, has a great quote. He says, "Sense of place complex? We tend not to think so, mainly because our attachment to places, like our attachment, like our ease with which we usually sustain those attachments, are taken for granted. As normally experienced, sense of place quite simply is." And I think that's a great way of considering the way that we think about our place attachments. It's true, they just are really a part of who we are. So this can make it really difficult to reflect on our own connection to place, and really to encourage others to think about it as well. So how do we define sense of place? Well, sense of place refers to the complex affective, cognitive, and evaluative, or values-based relationships that people have with their places. It's a multidimensional construct. In the environmental field and natural resource field, we often think of, in particular, we think of the biophysical dimension of place. We think of iconic places like Yosemite or Yellowstone or the Grand Canyon. We think of these really kind of sweeping landscapes and really focus on that biophysical element. But in reality, it doesn't really mean only the biophysical element. It also refers to the sociocultural elements of place. It refers to the psychological pieces of place and the political economic dimensions of place. When you think about a map, it's also divided up by thinking about what are the boundaries of places as well. So it also thinks about all those different ways, all those different dimensions of those relationships that people have with their places. More specifically, when we think about that broader term of sense of place, it's kind of hard to get our heads around that. So people who study sense of place like to break it down even further and try to think about what are some of the constituent aspects of sense of place. So some of the ways that we think about that are to divide it up into what we think of as place meanings and place attachments. Place meanings are what sociologist Richard Stedman calls the essence of the place. So what's really at the heart of the place, or what's really at the character of the place. And then place attachment is what anthropologists Altman and Lowe, in their classic 1992 book, they describe it as the affective and cognitive element of our relationship with place. So how do our relationships with places develop? So let's take a moment to actually reflect a little bit on places that might be special to you. So I'd like for you in just a minute to pause this video, and we're each going to take a moment to reflect on some places that are special to us. And what I'd like for you to do is just to think about a place, maybe a place that you visit a lot, maybe a place you've only visited once or twice, a place you maybe visit alone or with other people, and just take a moment to write down 3 or 4 words or 3 or 4 phrases about that place, and then we'll come back together in a moment. In reflecting on some of the ideas that some of you might have written down, I can imagine that some of the ways that you may have described the places that are special to you and some of the relationships you may have described are perhaps similar to those that are described in the literature. For example, a lot of people discuss places that they have visited many times over the course of their lifetime. Other people talk about places that are important to them because they use them often. Maybe there's a river that's particularly special to someone, or someone who likes to go into a city and visit a particular art gallery many, many times, or a college campus that someone has spent many years at over the course of their education. Also, we think a lot about the interaction with that place. A sense of place is not something that's static, but rather it's a relationship. So we think about building relationship with places and their dynamic over the course of time. And in particular, we think a lot about the social relationships that people have in places. So I'm guessing that many of you maybe described a place that's special to you because of interactions you had there with family or with friends. And we see that a lot in people's research about why relationships with places develop in special ways. We also see, too, that people describe iconic places. And the interesting thing about this is sometimes they're places that people maybe have never even visited. They're places that you know about as being special in your imagination. So think about places like the Galapagos, which we know is special because it's a place that was visited by Darwin, and it's really special to us for cultural reasons or scientific reasons. So now perhaps we're getting to the crux of the matter. Why does this matter for environmental education? Well, we often have this idea that if people love a place or people care about a place, then they'll do something to take care of it or to protect it. And if you think about what is environmental education, well, it's about this idea of getting people engaged in some kind of way in thinking about bettering society and bettering the environment for sustainability and for the future. And so then we think about these connections to places, and we think about what is it that people feel really motivated by in terms of their connection to places, and does that really lead them to then want to do something, some kind of place protective action. The interesting thing about the literature around connection to place, sense of place, place attachment, is that the literature around this is a little bit mixed. I'll ask you to reflect back now on when we mentioned those dimensions of place, and I think a lot of the research shows that this might be because there are a variety of these dimensions. And it's that partially because our relationship with places are so complex. This is also partially because our perception of what it means to do something to protect a place is also complex. So to take care of a place for me might look different than for you. When I think of taking care of a place that's important to me, I might envision the biophysical place, whereas for you, you might envision your sociocultural elements of a place, or maybe your social relationships in a place. One last aspect that I'll mention for now is that our vision of what scale of place means is also very different for different people. So you can imagine that a young child who's 5 years old or 8 years old or even 10 years old might have a very different envisioning of what his or her scale of place might be from someone who's my age. So my vision of what my place looks like would be very different from that young child's vision of his or her place and their ability to get engaged in doing something around taking care of their place. So I'd just like to end by suggesting, what is it that we know in environmental education, and what is it that we talk about in environmental education around people and their places? Well, we often hear people talk about this notion of place-based education, which is a really powerful concept because everyone does something in a place. We're all grounded in some kind of place, whether it's your place or someone else's place or a collective idea of place, whether it's an online space in the world in which we're existing today. Yet all of this is existing in some kind of context that's a place-based context. And so we can think about, again, referring back to that young child, we can think about that young child, their place might be a place that's very small now, and yet it's very helpful for us to think about how do we help people understand that place within these larger spheres of influence. How in environmental education do we help people understand their ability to be effective in collaboration with other people? So what are the kinds of actions and efficacy and the kinds of skills and the kinds of values that we might help people develop that help them understand how their place might connect to broader places? How their knowledge of their place or their knowledge of other places might connect with knowledge of other places. Sense of place is studied in many different fields, everything from anthropology to sociology, geography, political science, natural resource management, and environmental education. It's also really critical. It's really critical for us to understand the ways in which people feel connected to their places, feel motivated by their places, feel that they're part of a community.